Several families have been thrown into mourning as a result of untimely death of their loved ones arising from the Debe Lassa fever, which is caused by an infection with the Lassa virus spread by rats.
Oh yes, the rats that live in large numbers around us, they carry the virus in their urine and feces and live in the homes and areas where food is stored.
So, the ingestion of foods and drinks contaminated by the saliva, urine and feces of infected rats, catching and preparing infected rats as food, inhaling tiny particles in the air contaminated with infected rat urine or dropping, and direct contact with a sick person's blood or bodily fluids through the mucous membrane such as the eyes, the nose, the ears, or the mouth are ways of getting infected.
Early symptoms of the disease which occur within the first 3 weeks of coming in contact with virus include fever, headache, chills, diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, sore throat, backache and joint pains. Late symptoms include bleeding from the eyes, the ears, the nose, bleeding from the mouth, rectum, the eye swelling, swelling of the genitals and rashes all over the body that often contains blood.
It could progress to coma, shock and eventually death.
Yes, please. The good news, however, is that Lassa fever can be prevented. Oh yes, early detection and diagnosis greatly aids treatment, preventable death, and curtails further spread of the virus. We should know, however, that preventing Lassa fever in the community is first about preventing the source, and that is why it's important to observe good personal hygiene by keeping our houses clean and the environment as well, so as to discourage rodents from entering our homes.
Some more measures that can be put in place is to avoid contact between rats and human beings by blocking out all rat hideouts. Options of fumigation can also be looked at for some bushy environments.
Absolutely. Please ensure you dispose your waste properly and clean the environment so that the rats are not attracted.
Store foodstuffs in rodent-proof and airtight containers.
And above all, also ensure you cook all food thoroughly. Discard any food item that might have been contaminated in any form by rats.
Practice constant hand washing with soap and water. Promote a better personal hygiene.
And as soon as you suspect Lassa fever or you have persistent fever not responding to the standard treatment for malaria and typhoid, please kindly report to the nearest health facility.
Or call the following numbers.
Together, let us build a healthy nation.